Students, today we will see the next part of the lesson, triangle, and the lesson name is the triangle. And today we will see the median of a triangle. So what is median? So suppose this is triangle ABC. In figure, here it is triangle AB ABC, and D is the midpoint of seg BC. This is BC, and this is the D is the midpoint of which? BC. Therefore BD equals to DC. Okay, and when we join this AD, okay, this midpoint and this vertex, then this line AD is called as a median. This is called as a median of a triangle. So AD is the median of the what? Triangle. So what is the definition of median? The vertex which joins the midpoint of the opposite segment is called as opposite segment of a triangle. That line is called as a median. Okay, so this is the median. So first of all, here it is a definition of median. The segment joining vertex and midpoint of side. So this is the vertex and this is the midpoint of side BC. If we join this, then it is, this figure is AD is called as a median. It is called as a median of a triangle. In figure, here in this figure, D is the midpoint of BC. This is D and it is the midpoint of BC. Therefore AD is a median. This AD is median of triangle ABC. Okay, now here activities are given to you. What we have to do? Now here in this triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, this is the first activity, and that activity inside what they told us, in activity here it is triangle ABC. Draw the medians AD, BE, CF. So E is the midpoint of AC, D is the midpoint of BC, and F is the midpoint of AB. And you have to join these midpoints with the opposite vertex of that side. So BF we join, AD if we join, and FC when we join. So these are the medians of the triangles, three medians of the triangle. And their point of concurrence is G. So here it is point G, and this point is a point of concurrence. Point of concurrence means if three or more lines passing from a single point, then that point is called as a point of concurrence, which is called as a centroid of the triangle. As you know that this construction we had done last year, maybe it was there. Otherwise, in your intelligence exam is there. No, drawings exam is there. Inside it, these types of questions are there. So by taking the G as a center, and it is centroid. So if we draw the circle for this figure, okay, which is passing from point A, B, C, then what happens, it is passing from that all the vertex of the triangle. So this is the, which is called as a centroid of the triangle. Compare the length of AG. We have to measure AG, then BG and CG. Compare the length of AG and GD with divider. Verify AG is twice the length of GD. So here what they told you, we have to measure AG and GD. So here it is AG and GD. If you measure it, GD suppose it is 2 cm, then AG is 4 cm. Means GD is double is AG. Okay. So AG is twice the length of GD. So that we, you will notice. Same thing is that GE is half of BG. G's measure is half of BG. And same FG is half of GC, otherwise GC is double or twice the FG. This is the activity. So you just measure, you have to do this activity in your notebook. First of all of you draw the triangle, take the midpoints of every segment, and that what points you just join this with the opposite vertex of the triangles. And after that what we have to do, after drawing this, you have to so after taking the midpoint, we have to join this with the opposite vertex, and you will get the point G, that is the point of concurrence, and from this you have to measure the distance of midpoint to this point of concurrence and vertex to point of concurrence. You will notice that this is double than that of the GD. Means this activity you have to do, and you have to send me on my number, on my personal number. Hence, note the following property of median of the triangle. So, what is the property? The property is that the point of concurrence of a median. This is the point of concurrence of the medians of a triangle. Divide each median. Divide each median into 2:1. 2:1 ratio. So, for example, suppose this is 4 and that is 2. If you find the ratio 4:2 means 4 divided by 2, 2 1s are 2 and 2 2s are 4. Means so how is the ratio? 2:1 is the ratio. In that way, what happens? It divides this median. Next, second activity is the, in this second activity, we have to draw one triangle on a cardboard. Here it is the cardboard, that triangle is there. Then on that triangle, draw its median and denote their point. So we have to draw the medians for this. This is a median here given. So these are the medians. And after getting the drawing the median on it, what we have to do here, you will get the, as you know that you will get the point of concurrence, and that point of concurrence is G. Okay, so what they told you, draw the median, denote their point by point of concurrence as a G, cut out triangle. Triangle we have to cut. Now take pencil and try to balance the triangle on the flat tip of the pencil. Okay, flat side we have to take and we have to try to balance it. The triangle is balanced only when the point G on the flat tip of the pencil. Means that flat tip, if it is under or below the G, point G or point of concurrence, then only what happens, that triangle get balanced. This activity shows an important property of centroid of the triangle, and which is that point of concurrence of the median. So this is the centroid, and that centroid balances the triangle, and it shows that this activity shows the important property of centroid. Okay, now the here it is the activity given. This is also the property of median only. Drawn to the hypotenuse of a right angle. Okay, so here it is in this figure. ABC is a right angle triangle. Okay, if you see here, this is ABC is right angle triangle, and ABC, this angle ABC is equal to how much? 90 degree. Okay, and D is the median of the AC. D is the median of the AC, and afterwards what we have to do here? So in this activity, this triangle ABC is right angle and BD is the median. Okay, why BD is the median? If you see the figure, AD and DC, these are the congruent lines, and this BD is there. This BD is a what? Median of a triangle. Triangle and AC is hypotenuse, and AC is hypotenuse, and hypotenuse median, midpoint is D, and BD is the median of it. Now what they told you, you have to measure the length of the following. What we have to measure? The lengths of the following. AD, then DC, BD. Okay? BD. That measures we have to do. So you will notice that in a right angle triangle, BD is equal to 1/2 AC. Okay? BD. So if you see here, if its measure is 3 and BD is also 3 will come. So here it is 3, 3. So AD plus DC is equal to 6 and BD is equal to 1/2 AC, means BD's measure is half of hypotenuse. Okay, and now let us prove the property, and the length of the median is half the length of its hypotenuse. In a right angle triangle, the median is half of the length of the hypotenuse. That we will see by theoretically. So here it is a theorem given. So we will see the theorem at first. So, the theorem, median's theorem is that in a right angle triangle, what they told you, in a right angle triangle, the length of median of the hypotenuse is half of the length of hypotenuse. So, here the part of the statement, in a right angle triangle. So, here it is, this is a right angle triangle A, B, C. this is right angle triangle ABC. Angle B is equals to 90 degree. Okay, B is equal to 90 degree and D, point D is the midpoint of AC and BD is its a median. So here in a right angle triangle, length of median of hypotenuse. So this is the median of hypotenuse. Median's hypotenuse means AC is median hypotenuse and its midpoint is D and BD is the median of hypotenuse, is half the length of hypotenuse, means BD is half of AC, that we have to prove. From given inside, what will come then? In triangle ABC, this angle B is equals to 90 degree and BD is its median. So we have to write it in the given, that is in triangle ABC, B is equal to 90 degree and BD is the median. Okay, now what we have to prove, that BD, measure of this BD is half of AC, that we have to show. BD is there, this is BD and it is half of AC, that we have to show. So first of all, to prove this, we have to do one construction. What construction we have to do? That is, take point E on ray BD. This point E we have to take. We have to first of all increase its increase this BE. Okay, in that way we have to increase. And on this ray BD, what we have to do? We have to take point E. How we have to take that point E? That point E So here it is, point E. Now how to do this construction, that I will show you. Okay, so first of all, we have to draw a right angle triangle. So this is right angle triangle and I have to join the A, B, C is right angle triangle and B is the right angle and AC is hypotenuse and midpoint of AC is suppose D, the midpoint of AC is suppose D, and we have to join this, okay, with a line. So this is BD is the median of, BD is median of a triangle ABC. Okay, now we have to take the point E on this BD, ray BD. So this is ray BD, I will increase it. Okay, and we have to take point E. So where we have to take point E? How much is the BD major? There I had taken here point E. Okay, now join this E C. Okay, if I will join this EC, okay, now here it is the figure. Now here are two triangles. Which are those two triangles? First triangle is the this ADB and another triangle is this one EDC. Okay, so these two triangles are there. If we are able to show these two triangles congruent to each other, then what happens? We can show that BD is half of AC. So first of all, how we can show these two triangles are congruent to each other? So here, as you know that AD, measure of AD is equals to AD, measure of AD means this is AD is equals to AD is equal to AC. Okay, AD, seg AD is congruent to seg ADC. Okay, next we have to show that as per know that this BD, seg BD is congruent to seg ED. Okay, and this is vertically opposite angle. Angle ADB is congruent to angle EDC, angle EDC. Okay, if these two sides and these two sides, and this is a angle vertically opposite, this region is the vertically opposite angle, and these are the what it is given, and this one is the construction. So if it is congruent to each other, then triangle ADB, this triangle ADB and another triangle DEC, these two are congruent to each other by SAS test of similarity. Okay, so that we will see here in the figure. So first of all, here they took here two triangles, these are ABD and another triangle is DCE. So here in this triangle inside, AD is congruent to DC, AD is congruent to DC, BD is congruent to DE. Okay, and this angle, vertically opposite angles are congruent to each other. That steps I told you, here I told you, you have to complete this. This is also the activity. Here the steps which are above this, just now I shown, whenever I shown that figure at that time. So these two triangles you have to show congruent to each other. If they are congruent to each other, AB is parallel to AC by alternate angle test. Okay, now what we have to show, that next point, that is, if these two triangles are congruent to each other, then these angles which are ABD and which ADEC, these two angles are congruent to each other. Once they are congruent to each other, the line AB is parallel to line EC, means these two lines are parallel to each other. Okay, then once they are parallel to each other by alternate angle test, these two triangles again ABC and ECB, ABC and ECB, this also we have to show congruent to each other by SAS test of similarity. So how we can show that? First we have to show these two triangles congruent to each other, that is the first step. Next, what we have to show after that, if these two triangles are congruent to, just now I shown you how to do this, then you have to show these angles by CACT, angle BABD and DEC are congruent to each other by alternate angle test. Once they are congruent to each other, AB is parallel to DC, and if AB is parallel to DC, then we have to show that these two triangles, means which two triangles? This is ABC, this triangle is congruent to triangle ECD. If you are able to show these two triangles are congruent to each other, then easily you can show this, whatever our proof is there. So how we can show these two triangles congruent to each other? First of all, these are 90 degrees angle, okay, and this is the what, common side. So here we have to write angle B is congruent in triangle, which I told you, in triangle ABC, and another triangle is triangle ACE. In these two triangles inside, angle B is congruent to angle C. Okay, then afterwards here, this BC is a common side, BC is congruent to sec BC is congruent to sec BC. Okay, and next AB, as you know that how much AC is equals to BAE, that we have to show. And in first proof inside, what we shown, that ADC triangle, ADB and this DEC, these two triangles congruent to each other, and by CSCT, AB is congruent to EC, we have to show at that place. And then here what will come, sec BC is congruent to BC and AB is congruent to EC, sec AB is congruent to sec, which that sec, that is EC. Okay, this is, and therefore these two triangles, which triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ACE by SAS test of similarity. Therefore right here, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle, then these two triangles are congruent to each other. How I told you, AB is congruent to EC, this is common side and this is the right angles. So these two triangles ABC is congruent to EBC, and when they are congruent to each other, their corresponding sides are congruent to each other, means AC is equals to what we get it here, BE, seg AC is equal to seg BE, and once seg AC is equal to BE, D is the midpoint of AC is equal to what we have to write here, AC is equal to 1/2 AD. Okay, AD, AC is equal to, wait,
here we will write.
First of all, we have to show that AC is equal to which I told you, BE. AC is equal to B. Then here BE is equal to AC, and here in above, here in this statement, what as per construction, what we have to show that AC is equals to how much is there? D is the midpoint of AC. D is the midpoint of AC. Therefore, AC is equal to, if AC is equal to DE, BE, sorry, AC is equal to BE. Now, once they are, these two triangles are congruent to each other, we get AC is equal to BE. Both half do, one half AC, one half BE, one half AC, keep it as it is, one half BE. One half BE means what? BD. So just B, one half BD replace with the BE, replace with the BD. So you will get it here, one half AC is equal to BD, and that is our proof. Understand all of you? So in that way you have to show that BD is half of AC. So first of all, again I will repeat this. First you show these two triangles congruent to each other. This is you. This is for you. You have to do this. Okay, first these two triangles show congruent to each other, and then show AB is congruent to EC by CS CT. Once you show this AB is congruent to AC, then you have to take these two triangles for congruency. These two triangles, which AB C and BD C, these two triangles take for congruency, show congruent to each other. How to we will show? AB is congruent to AC, BC is a common side, and this is right angle. By SAS, these two triangles are also congruent to each other. Again, if that these two triangles are congruent to each other, you will get here, by CSCT you will get here AC is congruent to BE. You will get AC is equals to BE, and both half we have to do. One half AC, just keep it as it is, and one half BE is there, one half BE replace with the BD. Okay, so in that way you can prove this, what BD is half of AC. So this is there, you have to do this because it is the student's activity, and they told you to complete this point. Main steps are given, write the steps in between and reason to complete the proof. Well, you just try to solve this. I explain you better way. If you don't understand, then also just send me the message. You are not send me, then I will take it in the next lesson. Okay, so today we will stop here only. Okay, thank you and have a good day.